Welcome back to this video tutorial. Now we can consider some program examples for 8051. So this one is an example for adding two 8-bit numbers, and the numbers are present in internal memory bytes. So the one byte address is taken as 20 and is loaded into R0 register, and the second internal byte address 30 is loaded into R1 register, and here it moves the content of memory location whose address is available in R0 to accumulator register. Actually, R0 is pointing to a memory byte having the address 20. So, content from that location is located or moved into accumulator register first, then from A to R5. We need these two sequence of instruction because here in 8051, this type of data transfer mode is not valid. That means a general purpose register to another register, this particular type of instruction is not valid here in case of 8051. So we need to transfer data to accumulator register, then from accumulator to R5. So the first number is loaded to R5. Next, here it clear R4 register. Okay, R4 is loaded with immediate value 0. That means R4 is cleared here. Next, increment R0 content by 1, so that R0 now pointing to an internal memory byte address 21H. So move A, @R0 means from memory byte location 21H, load the content of that particular byte to A. Then now we can perform the addition, because one operand is available in A and the another is available already loaded in R5. So we must point or note here, the destination operand always must be accumulator in case of addition, subtraction and like other arithmetic operation. So A is placed here in the destination position and the other operand is placed here in the source position. So after addition, A plus R5 is performed and the content is placed back into accumulator. Then after this addition, check for the carry. If no carry is occurred or no carry is generated after this addition, then jump to a label named as save. So directly move here and store the resultant value of addition available in accumulator. So the resultant value is loaded into a memory location whose address is available in R1 register. We have already set here R1 is pointing, or R1 is having the byte address 30. So at 30th byte position, the result of addition is loaded. Then this particular instruction indicate a short jump to the loop having the name, or short jump to the label having the name halt. That means halt is the label for this particular instruction itself. That means while executing this, this will loop here in this last statement continuously. That means this one indicate the stop of the program execution. Right. So one more, if it generate a carry after this addition, then this condition become, this JNC instruction execution become fault. Okay, in that case, we don't want to jump directly to this label location save. Instead, we need to perform this increment operation. That means initially R4 is cleared. Here, this become R4 become 1 now after this increment operation. Then we need to transfer that register content of R4 to B. Then from B, we need to store that value to a memory location whose address is available in R1. And the R1 is already set as 30H. That means pointing to a particular internal memory byte having the address 30. To that location, it places the content of R4 in case of after addition, if it generate a carry, then at 30H byte position, it place the carry value, then increment R1 by 1, and now R1 pointing to 31H. Okay, so in 31H, it place the result value from accumulator, right? So in case of carry, 30H hold the carry value and 31H hold the result of addition. But in case of addition with no carry, then the 30H position hold the result of addition. Okay, so after storing both the carry and result of addition, it stopped while executing this particular instruction. So this is the input and output. Initially 20 is loaded with 5F, and in 21H it placed the second operand D8, and 30 after this addition it generated carry, so the 30 is loaded with value 01. That means this instruction execution get violated, and so it's continue the sequential code of instruction execution. So 30H is loaded with the carry value 01 and 31H is loaded with the result of addition and is available in accumulated register. Okay, so this is the case of 2 8-bit number addition, and the operands are available in internal memory space itself. Now we can consider another program example, but the difference is here the operands, 2 operands are available in external memory location. Okay, in the previous case the operands are available in internal memory byte itself, and also after the addition the result is placed back into another internal memory byte location. But here we need to take the operands from external memory bytes, and after the operation we need to write the result value back into external memory byte, so that we need to use this particular data pointer. So first move the external memory byte address to DPTR, then from that location the content is loaded into accumulator register with the help of this MOVX instruction. So this is the main difference while we are dealing with the external memory bytes. We need to use the DPTR for pointing the external memory bytes, and also we need to use the MOVX instruction for transferring data to or from the external memory bytes. Okay, now this instruction MOV F0A means content of accumulator result is loaded into an address location F0 in internal memory. Actually this F0 is the direct address of register B. We can use the name B or we can use this direct address for the special function register B. B's address is actually F0. So the content from 9800 is now available in B register. Then increment DPTR by 1. Then using the same MOVX instruction, now from 9801 the value is loaded into accumulator register itself. So now one operand is available in B register, another is available in A register. Now here we are going to perform this division operation. For the division operation, the dividend must be available in A and divisor must be available in B. So the first we taken the divisor and is placed into B, and second we entered the dividend and is available in accumulator register itself. So after division, we know that the result or quotient is available in A register and the remainder is available in B register. Right, so using the same DPTR we need to point another external memory address to which we need to store both the quotient and remainder value. So here it indicate 9200 is the location to which we need to store the resultant value. Then MOVX at the rate DPTR, A, that means content of our the quotient of division is available in accumulator and is placed into the location pointed by DPTR, and the that location here it is 9200. For this particular external memory data transfer, we must use this MOVX instruction instead of simple MOV instruction. Right, after that the content from B register is loaded back into accumulator, then increment DPTR by 1. That means now DPTR pointing to 9201, to which we need to store the remainder of division. So the reminder is now available in accumulator. So that is loaded into the memory byte, external memory byte pointed by DPTR, and is actually 9 to 0. Okay, now the entire division operation and the result quotient and the reminder is loaded into two different bytes of external memory. Now we can stop here using or cycling in the same instruction. Okay, so this one indicate the usage of DPTR for accessing external memory, and the previous program example is actually for accessing internal memory. Okay, one more point we need to remember here is, for internal memory space we use actually 8 bit address information, and for external memory addressing we use 16 bit address information. Okay, thank you.